Here I'm going to discuss a proving question based on the trigonometric ratio of standard angles. So first you need to understand what is standard angle. Standard angle, whenever I'm saying in trigonometry, then you need to understand those angle whose value we can find out without using calculator, without using scientific calculator or trigonometric table. All right. I mean any angle which is the multiple of 15. All right. Those angles trigonometric ratio we can easily find out. Keep in mind, all right, 15 times x is any integer, so you can easily find out the trigonometric ratios like tan 15 degree, sine 15 degree, cotangent of 15 degree, secant of 15 degree, anything you can find out, or any multiple of 15, like I meant to say like 30 degree, 45 degree, you know, 60 degree, similarly 90 degree, 120 degree, 135 degree, and so on, you know, any trigonometric such degrees ratio we can easily find out, right, without using calculator. So these angles generally we say standard angles in trigonometry. Keep that in mind, right? So here we have now this question. We need to prove this, and one more thing I want to tell you, whenever you see pi related angle, you know, so first you need to check up whether that is in standard form or not. So to check that, simply what you can do, you can remove this pi by 180 degree, because we know that pi radian equals to 180 degree. So pi over 6 radian will be equals to 180 degree divided by 6. That's going to be 30 degree. Similarly, here we have pi over 3. So it's going to be pi over 3 radian. Here you might not be seeing radian, right? They have ignored it. So it's 180 degree divided by 3, that's 60 degree. Similarly, pi 5 pi by 6, all right, so it's 5 pi over 6, that's going to be 5 times 180 degree divided by 6, so it's going to be 6 times 3, 5 times 3, that's 150 degree. All right, another one is pi over 4, pi over 4, pi is 180 degree. All right, here is a radian divided by 4, so 4 2 times 2, 2 times 90, and 2 times 4.5, that's 45 degree, right? So it's 45 degree. So now see, 45 degree, 150, 60, and 30, all are divisible by 15. So since these all are divisible by 15, means you can find out the trigonometric ratio of any of these angles without using calculator. So means you just put the values of everything here, or sometimes if you feel difficult, then you can use other tricks also. All right, so I'm just going to solve it. So it's 3 times sine pi by 6. Sine pi by 6 means sine, and recently I told you pi by 6 is 30 degrees, so sine 30 degrees 1 over 2, and secant of pi by 3, that is 60 degree. Now generally students learn less, most of the students I have seen, I mean they don't try to remember the formula related to secant, cotangent, and cosecant, because they are smarter, you know. Why? Because they just reciprocal the trigonometric ratio of the same angle of sine, cosine, and tangent. Because like in this case, secant is the reciprocal of cosine, you know. So if you know the value of cosine pi by 3, that is 60 degree, which is 1 by 2, then definitely you can easily write, you know, secant of 60 degree, that's just a reciprocal of this, that's 2, you know, 2 over 1. So you just do there, just put the value of sec pi by 3, that's going to be 2. Okay, now further, 4 sine pi by 6, all right, so it's what I told you, sine 150 degree. Okay, so sine 150 degree value you can easily find out, all right, if you are not remembering the trigonometry table. It's actually sine 30 degree equals that's 1 by 2, but how it came, let me show you once again. It's sine 150 degree, right? You can do like this, sine 180 degree minus 30 degree, all right, that's equals to sine 30 degree. Why? Look at here, use the quadrant rule, all right. Sine 150 is coming in somewhere like this, you know, 150 degree. It means it's in the second quadrant. So what I did, I choose the pi, you know, pi, I mean 180 degree, I choose pi minus how much, 30 degree, you know, 30 degree, that's pi by 6, or you can say simply 180 degree minus 30 degree. So in this region, you know, as I told you, in this region the trigonometric ratio do not change whenever you you write 180 plus theta or minus theta. Minus theta will lead to second quadrant, and plus theta, 180 plus theta will lead you to the third quadrant. All right, every time whenever you taking the reference of this, that there is no change in that in the trigonometric ratio, but sign matters, the positive and negative matters. Now 180 minus 30, that is second quadrant, 150 second quadrant, and second quadrant sign value is always positive, so that's why this is positive sine 30, and that's 1/2. And always keep in mind that in this region, 90 and 270 degree region, this is 90 degree region, this is 270 degree region, the trigonometric ratio changes. All right, keep in mind that. So let's put all the values. It's 4, and now sine pi by 6, as I told you, it's sine 30, so it's 1/2. And now cotangent of pi by 4, you must be knowing pi by 4, that's 45 degree. And if you don't know the formula of cotangent of pi by 4, no problem at all, you just remember the formula of tangent of pi by 4. Yes, that's one. And reciprocal of tangent of 45 degree, that's one only. All right, because we know the formula, it's very easy, equals to 1. I further, it's 2 and 2 will cancel up, you'll get 3 minus 2 times 2, so it's 2 equals to 1, so it's further 1 equals to 1, and that's proved. All right, there might be many questions you have to ask, then please feel free to comment below this video. I will definitely reply back, and if there is any more question related to this, you're confusing or difficult, then please share with me. If I'll get the chance, definitely I'll help you there. Right, goodbye.